friends, the hardest thing we face in the world today is simply to be somebody. To stand up and be counted as something. To be known by friend and foe alike as a man, woman, or child with the courage to hold our head high in the name of what we believe in. Brothers and sisters in Christ, every day I see the power of Almighty God manifest in the strength of my strong army of soldiers for Jesus. These men and women join me in my great crusade across this great state, doing battle with Satan, who each and every day claims more souls. Come join our army of courageous soldiers. Give the strength of your good hearts to the cause of glory here and ever after. In the name of him who no army can defeat, no power can topple, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
Your town and you can help us get there.
The words of Jesus. I thought I told you to water them chickens.
I did.
Well, then how come the trough is as dry as a desert?
Your own Christian love will
lose them chickens. See, I expect to put food on this table.
Send your contribution to Campaign for Christ, Post Office Box 796.
Hey, do I gotta listen to that thing while I'm trying to eat?
God bless you. In whom the gospel.
Well, as of this minute, you people are eighth graders. What are you waiting for? Class dismissed.
Bye.
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 Gemma, I made you a little something. Nothing really, just for doing so good in your studies. For always raising your hand when I needed help with something.
Needlepoint?
Crocheting. A bookmark.
Thank you.
You wasn't trying anything dumb.
Like what?
Like, I don't know, but I saw you putting your big old foot in that door.
If she didn't need him, she wouldn't have ordered him.
Yes, she would. It's called railroading.
Miss Cole's gonna be taking 2 dozen next week.
Cole's ain't had more than a dozen in all the years I've been bringing them eggs.
Yeah, well, I think Miss Cole's been wanting a little man to carry her over to the ball this year.
Listen, I've known Miss Cole too long, too many years. Start thinking of her that away, I can tell you. Why, she's the fattest old girl in town.
Yeah, well, she'd call you up if you had a phone.
When nothing else could help, love lifted me.
I was thinking you was my neighbor woman.
You don't know who I am. Of course you don't.
I know you. You don't look like any of them pictures we got. But I know you.
Where is he?
Out back.
My God, I hope I don't look like them pictures anymore. I hope I've been doing something right.
Pop told me you had brown hair like mine.
Shoot. Maybe it was. I can't remember. He be coming to the house soon?
Maybe.
Gemma. Gemma. I'm your mama. Baby, I can't stay long. Got to be getting back to Fort Worth. That's where I'm living now, baby, in Fort Worth.
Pop says they got different water fountains there for the color people.
Did he now? Well, it figures that's what he'd be saying. Baby, he don't know nothing. He must have heard something about that 30 years ago. That's all he remembers.
Do they?
He don't know what they got. Anyway, I reckon I best be getting over there. Tell him I'm here. The sooner we get that over with and put your things together, the sooner we'll get going, huh? Hey!
Hey, where do you think you're going? See there? That isn't any way for a young lady to be standing. You look like a farmhand.
Well, that's what I am.
Oh, no, you're not. You're one L. King's daughter, and you ain't gonna start off your life as some hick.
I done started my life, and I ain't going nowhere.
Gemma. Gemma, I hadn't been able to come for you yet because I had to have... I needed more than just some room somewhere. I had to have me a home.
Well, I got me a home. I had me one for 13 years right here.
Well, I know you got a home. I was the one that brought you to it. You still have all them chickens? He wants somebody to do his dirty work. Believe you me, I know. Did the exact same thing with my mama, too, till she had sense enough to leave, and she just got out. Baby, when I was 15, I hurt so bad, I thought I was sure to die in my sleep. I don't want that happening to you.
Well, it ain't.
You don't know yet. You just don't know. Hell with it now. I just want you to go inside and get your things together. Hey, Gemma.
I ain't leaving. I got all I need here.
You're just as hard-headed as he is.
I don't want him finding you here.
No skin off my nose. Woo! Just like him. You know it? You're just like him. Here. Send me a Christmas card.
Pop, how come I go by Dillard if my daddy's name was Monroe? Do I have the Monroe forehead? Pop, we have to get going.
Hey, hush, you're scaring my fish.
Bob and Doreen are probably wondering what happened to me.
Hey, Gemma. I got him, Gemma.
Do it yourself.
Oh, yeah. Looky here. Hey, come on. Help me get another grasshopper on this hook. Come on.
And just how you expect to get home? You see that lightning?
All right.
You gotta get those headlights fixed. You're gonna have to ride up front on the hood.
All right, let me have the flashlight.
See, we'd have been stuck by lightning if we'd stayed.
You just watch yourself.
I'm late for church, Pop. I'm driving there first.
Oh, no, you're not. You're gonna take me straight home.
You can sit through the service. It wouldn't hurt.
I'm telling you, girl, you get in there and drive me to the farm.
But, Pop...
Now just take it slow so you don't bounce me off. Come on, drive. Hey, take it easy. You tucked me over.
You fathers must not goad your children to resentment, but must give them the instruction and the correction which belongs to a Christian upbringing.
Hey! Hey! Take it easy!
I'm going to church.
Stop this car! Hey, watch it! You're gonna get it, girl! You're gonna get it! Gemma! Gemma, come here! I told you to take me home! Stop! Get it! Come on!
I'm gonna tame you high!
Beecham.
I do, Homer.
Don't put that thing in your mouth.
Seen you a couple nights ago over to the church. But I reckon you didn't see me.
Have a good day, Beecham.
Nice setting with you, Gemma.
All right, see you Sunday and bring your harmonica.
Sure enough. Homer, remember them songs you and me used to play together? We sure was good.
Well, let's go. I got ice cream melting.
I didn't know you had a harmonica. Still got it?
I don't want you messing with him. What would people think if they saw you sitting in a parked car like that?
Plays dominoes with me.
What?
Down at the church, Sunday nights. He's one of God's children like you. Besides, you and him was friends when you was little.
Hmm.
He was. He told me y'all used to go fishing and hoe cotton. How come you didn't stay friends?
Times change.
He was...
Now listen, you can pick the ones you're gonna go through this life with. It's plain common sense to see that some are better than others.
I didn't pick you.
Well, girlie, I didn't pick you neither. Now, that there was Billy Boy. You know, sometimes they ask me to play at their square dance.
Is that where you and Beecham used to play?
They had dances every month back then. Yeah, all leading up to the Twilight Harvest Ball. Oh, your grandma sure did love to go to that one. Made her and me king and queen in the whole shebang one year.
You?
Beecham don't know nothing about square dancing. Them people is never allowed. Hey. I got an idea. I'm going to show you how we did it. Now, come on, let's go out here. We got some rope. Nice, stand right over here. See, here we are. Now, this place, start right there. Where you're starting from, they call that home. Yeah, now, first thing you do, honor your partner. I bow to you, you curtsy to me. You know how to curtsy? Put your left foot back, bend your knee, that's it, I bow to you. Now, when they call do-si-do, okay, you put your right shoulder, all right, back to back, circle around, that's it, and come back home. Now, when they say promenade, give me your right hand, left hand under, that's right, and we do a little walk right around here, promenade, promenade. Home. When they say swing your partner, put your left hand on my shoulder. That's it. All right. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Home. Yeah, that's good. I'm gonna put some music on here. Put a smile on your face. Everybody dance right in your place. Honor your partner. And the ladies to your left. All join hands and you circle left. Circle left all the way around, Grandma Billy, till you come home. And you swing yours and leave mine alone. Everybody swing. Grandma Billy. One, two, three, four. And then we promenade. 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 Till you come home. Wing that lady, cause she's a young thing and cannot leave her mother. Yeah, well, ain't that something, huh? Yeah, I coming back.
Ain't nothing hard about it.
Oh, it's been a long time. It's coming back. Now that we just did, that was called square dance. Phew. Don't forget, it was me who taught you.
La 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 la. Charming Billy, for she's a young thing and cannot leave her mother.
I called everybody down there at the church.
I think I hear him down here.
Bubba, get out there before you break your neck. There must be 10 feet of garbage over here. How do you expect to get through all that mess?
What happened?
Oh, Beecham never could do nothing right.
What happened? Beecham, where is he?
Maybe I ought to go fetch my tractor.
No, we got to do this by hand. Tractor crushed daylights out. They ain't crushed out already.
Gentlemen, let's wait. Let's get organized.
Which way step?
Y'all found him yet? Is he dead?
I didn't see him standing there. I might have. He's always out here. But I didn't see him till it was too late.
We pushed the switch before we saw him. He was standing down here with all that junk around him, reading the back of a dumb old cereal box.
Beecham can't read.
Next thing I know, right out of nowhere, a ton of trash comes right down on him.
What do you mean, out of nowhere? If I'm not mistaken, it came right out the back end of your truck.
Doreen, it's Beecham.
I know, honey. We was just setting out the covered dish supper at church when Bob called.
Jordan! Come help! They covered Beecham!
Bad luck, go away.
I didn't know anybody was in here. We sure do enjoy having Gemma at the church.
Yeah, well, why don't you keep her?
Jimmy Dillard, your great daddy's gonna have a fit when he sees how black your hands are getting. It's Beecham down here!
When I come here, I'd never been to a church that had a colored person singing.
Thank
gonna get my boys home. Besides, everybody's finished with my food.
Mercy, I don't believe he's down there at all.
Maybe he ain't. We dug 12 foot. If we dug one, he ain't nowhere in sight.
You call me a liar, Hadley?
I ain't calling anybody a liar. But where is he? Now, where is he? I'm heading home. Beat him or no beat him, I got cows to milk.
I think we all best be getting back. What do you say?
Well, that ain't no Christian way to be acting.
Jimmy, it was a mistake, that's all. We'd have found Beecham if he was down there.
None of us looked hard enough.
Half the town was down here. He just ain't down there.
Jim, it's getting late. They add up the pie.
You're gonna have to help me.
Oh, you smell. You smell like I don't know what. Now, look, I'm starting this car. I'm going home and eating my suppers. If you want to come with me, fine. If not, to hell with you.
Pop!
Look, nobody else but you believes that Beecham got himself buried. Did you think of that? Oh, you're acting like a fool.
I'll get everybody rounded up and in the cars. Where you going now?
Y'all can't just leave him down here.
Well, where you be putting him? Maybe he's sang in y'all's church, but he won't be buried over there in the white folks cemetery. No, ma'am. Beecham be home.
Oh, Beecham.
Left over, them don't look like no account. We better catch us another batch before we head down yonder tomorrow. What the heck's that?
You know, the wages of sin is death.
I'm gonna blister you good.
Damn old stupid.
He's one of God's children.
Well, he ain't nothing now, so shut up.
My mama was here just the other day. She come for me all the way from Fort Worth.
You're lying. You're standing in line to me.
No, I ain't. And I ain't living with you anymore.
Well, where do you think you're gonna go? I took you in, gave you that room and that, kept you here all these years?
Well, I'll give you the money to pay you back.
I ain't looking for no reward. Besides, you can't pay me back all that time. You don't know anything about time yet. You ain't old enough.
I decided. I'm going to my mama's.
No, I decided. And that's right. You are.
me, sir. I just give this address for Miss Frank King. Is Miss Frank King here?
Yeah, she's here.
She lives in a gas station?
Why, Nell lives upstairs. We got us a place upstairs. I'm Frank King.
Oh. I'm Gemma Dillard. My mama told me her name was Mrs. Frank King.
Why, Nell expecting you?
Oh, I reckon she ain't.
How'd you get here?
I took the bus and hitched me a ride.
Don't you know you ought not be catching rides with strangers?
I won't do it no more.
Go on up them steps there and surprise your mama.
I thought you was Frank. Well, what brings you to Cowtown? Oh, where are my cigarettes? Frankie's always doing this to me. Bingo. Hey, I got to be shaking a leg. Boy, this place is like an oven, I swear. I got that thing flipped up to frigid and I'm still about to fry. So, you had enough of him?
Oh, I just decided I wanted to come live with you now.
I know, kiddo. I bailed out of there in the middle of the night, too. I got to go to the shop. There's a stack of wigs piled yay high. Don't have any idea that it's my day off. There's some enchiladas in the fridge if you're hungry.
No, I ain't.
Okay. You wouldn't mind washing up them dishes, would you?
No, I'll do it.
And eat them enchiladas if you want.
Okay.
Yeah. It's 1220 on KVLP, the heart of the Great Southwest.
Would y'all look here at this girl? Boy, I mean.
That looks real good on you, Gemma. Suit your face, huh?
Oh, I sure do wish I had me a picture, a before picture.
There she is, one more desirous creature about to hit the Jacksboro Highway.
Shh. Come soak Ms. Weeks' fingers for me. Seems like my hair just grows so fast.
I read in a magazine last week that the more you cut your hair, the more it grows.
I think it's got something to do with the time of year, too.
Could be.
Why now? Hair grow faster in the summer.
Shoot, I don't know. Mine hadn't grown a quarter inch all year.
It's because of that color you use. Now cut that out. You're gonna have these women afraid to tint their hair.
I reckon I don't mind if it doesn't grow. Better than this gray hair showing through before it should.
Amen. What is it, kiddo? Now you want a new pair of glasses like Aggie's?
Ooh, spider.
Oh,
why'd you do that?
You want no spiders running loose in here.
Heavens, no.
Ooh-wee, long-legged spiders mean bad luck.
I ain't living nowhere where there's any spiders once Frank's deal starts paying off. I don't care where I got to go. I'll leave Texas.
Mercy.
You ain't leaving one, L.
Oh, yeah? Why would I stay in this hole if I didn't have to?
Well.
Ooh, no offense, Aggie. You gotta be plumb nuts to think I'd stay living over a gas station. One thing to pump it, hon. It's another to take it out of the ground.
Well, I know how to pump it. But I sure don't know nothing about no oil.
Oh, if you left Juanelle, I'd never find another hairdresser like you.
You'll find one. Okay. Go get a towel, baby.
Well, you are mighty lucky. You were always lucky, though. You ought to see them over at the stagecoach, falling over themselves to sit next to Juanelle.
Start with a cuticle. Dry her hand first. There. You look much better without them.
Ooh, what a pretty face.
Everything's blurry.
That's just because your eyes ain't focused yet. Look like $1 million, baby. Have you working here in no time. As soon as we can persuade some man to take Gwen off our hands.
I'll say.
Hi, Rory.
What on earth is he doing?
Now, don't you be pestering my customers, honey. You know, you sure fiddle some pretty tunes on that thing.
Don't you be bothering that boy. I about got your mama's hair done.
Come on, we're going to look at some pretty pictures.
Right here. There you go. Poor thing. Probably can't even read. What's it say, Rory?
Say how to make a chicken casserole.
Oh, yeah? How does it say you make a chicken casserole?
You take your cane and mushroom soup, and you take your chicken and you wash him.
Ain't he something?
Well, he's something, all right.
Now, y'all don't be egging him on.
Me?
Rory, am I egging you on?
I think you do. In the casserole. I ain't read down that far yet. I make it for my mom's supper tonight.
Well, that's a good boy. Your Dolores will love that. Rory, this here's my daughter, Gemma.
I'm making a casserole.
Here's your mama's hair. Now take it straight home and don't stop anywhere along the way.
Good looking boy. Such a shame.
Looks mighty fit to me.
Fit as a fiddle.
Is my last name Monroe?
Why are you asking that?
Well, that's what Pop told me. He said my daddy's name was Monroe.
You don't know nothing. I don't know why I go and tell you a thing like that.
Well, that's what he said. But I go by Dillard.
He's an old fool. He still eat with his face down to the plate. He used to burn me up doing that. Well, I expect he does. You do yourself sometimes.
You got any pictures of my daddy?
No, I don't.
Well, I know he was in the war. I used to cut out pictures. When I was little, I used to cut out pictures in the magazines of all the soldiers. I thought they might be him. I dreamt about him for a real long time. Even after Pop told me he'd been killed over there.
That old buzzard tell you that?
He said he died fighting for our country. He said if my daddy hadn't have been over there, we'd be speaking Russian right now. Alice Farley says they got a whole different alphabet than us. Her daddy was in Vietnam too, but he come back. How long was it after Grandma left Pop that she died?
That old man still tracked chicken shit through the house. Boy, that used to irk me no end. Well, she's down there staying at Aunt Lottie's, just a couple of months.
She just took sick and died.
Got a lot of egg customers now. Every Tuesday and Friday.
Big business, ma'am, huh?
Were you and my daddy together a long spell before he got called away to the war?
I don't remember. It's been a long time.
Well, Pop says that I got the Monroe forehead. Do I?
I reckon you do. Sure. Whew.
Sit home tonight and fry.
Hold it, Janet. You forgot your change.
I sure do like Frank.
Yeah, he's a sweetheart, all right. Did you ever?
About 450,000 times.
What is she fixing to do?
I don't know, but it looks like he's fixing to let her.
Look! Mama, look. I cut these. I help. Stay put. Look, this one here, 14 cent off. And this one, here's...
Get on home now.
But they're for Cambo suit.
What? Get on home.
They give you a mug if you send it in. They give you a mug.
You better be asleep by the time I get there. You hear?
I feel like dancing.
You gonna ask him?
No, ma'am. He's gonna ask me.
Hey, cowboy. You got something there to wet my whistle?
I got me a sticker patch on the other side of mine, Dolores' trailer house. Another day, I forgot about 18 go on my feet. Now I have to sit down, pull them out, because my Dolores should be at work. They still be itching me.
You should rub a little cornmeal and lemon juice on it. It'll take out the itch.
Read me a story. One about them bears and they eating their cereal.
I don't know that one. It ain't in my Bible or I'd know it.
Yeah, it is. I can read me that one every time.
What are you chewing on? Well, that's a good way for you to choke.
I know.
Did you know that Jesus Christ was your Lord and Savior? Didn't your mother ever take you to church?
Is that where they say them stories?
Yeah, sometimes.
And then Aggie took me there one time. But I don't like it. Make me draw pictures, sit by myself. You hear my fiddle?
Yeah. Play real good, Rory. Do you remember my name?
Gemma. I have my bum back.
All right. Don't go putting that thing in your mouth. You might swallow it or something. Who taught you to play that fiddle?
Nobody teach me. My Dolores, she say I got me an ear. Because I play songs right off the radio.
You mean you can just listen to a song and then just play it?
Yep.
Boy, I mean. Rory, I thought I told you not to put that nasty thing in your mouth. Give it to me. Give it to me. I'm getting rid of this thing once and for all. You're a bad boy.
I know. Give it back to me. Back.
Now, this here's the note. I hired these boys from Odessa to run a survey.
Now, this is my note for my second mortgage.
Yep, will be. And the cash will pay for the survey and keep them from foreclosing on me. Now, right here's the deed of trust.
Well, here it is. Here it is. And that about taps me out, Aggie.
Well, hon, you're going to be tapping a whole hell of a lot more before this is done.
Come over here, buddy. See these two lines right here? You take the third parallel of lot R2 over to the fourth boundary of lot R7 here. Draw a straight line right between them. You ever been out to West Texas?
Mm-mm.
There ain't nothing as far as you can see. But all wells just pumping. Yeah, we got us 18 at least.
At least. Sign that note and you're on board, buddy.
Shake my hand, Gemma. Shake the hand of a rich man.
Well, let's get this show on the road. I intend to have myself out on a yacht at this time next year. Hey, get on in there and get your bath. Frank and Aggie are discussing business.
Figure we can get something going on about the 1st of September. Maybe by then this mess will be straightened out with them camel jockeys.
Who?
Arab sugar.
Oh, shoot. I'm
about to bust.
Film them mattress again, Aggie. Darnell, you just want to buy Midland?
You and me will sit in bubble bath all morning if we want to.
You will?
Yep. And then we'll go shopping. Hey, you want to go to Robert Powers? Robert Powers Modeling School? I wish I had that chance. I'd be in Neiman's catalog right now, I'll bet. Tell me to take a bath with that thing, too. You tickle me to death the way you read that thing.
I want to go hear Brother Mosley. I hear he's preaching somewhere around here.
You take that stuff pretty serious, don't you? That's all right. I never studied the Bible or nothing, but I did go to Sunday school when I was little with Mama. And I started going again after she died. I went for almost a year, and I was saved and everything, the whole shooting match. Then this guy, he started coming to church. I liked him a lot. And pretty soon, we were sitting together, him and me. And sometimes during the Wednesday prayer meetings, he'd bend toward me and he'd give me a kiss. Nobody never noticed. We was always in the back over to one side. My girlfriends, they'd all sit in front so nobody'd see what was going on. He'd put one arm around me in the dark. And he'd slide his other hand up my leg during the prayer. And that just about made me fall to pieces. Shoot, I wasn't much older than you. I didn't know what was going on.
Was he my father?
Hey, what are y'all talking about in there?
Nothing, girl talk. Here you go. I know you told me it ain't happened yet, but you're gonna be a woman soon. I already got the knockers. You know, sometimes when a man and a woman get together, they make a baby in the woman.
I know about that stuff.
How do you know that stuff?
Doreen Hadley told me.
Busybody. Who does she think she is?
She just explained it to me in case I was wondering about any of it.
And were you? Wondering?
Yes.
Well, that's all right. Though Doreen probably mixed in some church stuff about marrying. Doesn't always work out like that. It's one thing to know how to have babies, and it's another to know how not to have them.
Do you wish you hadn't have done that with my father? Not had me?
I ain't sorry for nothing.
I was just wondering if you was glad I came here.
Do you like me to clang your bells with my boot heel, boy?
You are one hard cat.
to be teasing them boys.
What? Are you gonna die? What? You're gonna die. You're gonna die.
Oh, I knew I should have been there. I knew I should have gone over there tonight.
What? Just get on home.
Talking to me, saying you're fixing to meet the eighth wonder of the world. Good Lord. Good Lord.
Why, Nell, you know I don't like you spending your evenings down there.
Well, it's more than you offer here. We got to unwind.
I done told you how I feel about that.
Gwen and me do what we want, right, Gwen?
Right. So anyway, he gets me out there in his truck, and he says, hey, let's drive around. And then he starts telling me what he wants me to do. I mean, that's dangerous.
Why, Nell, you know we're going to make a killing on this thing.
And I
we're
said, gonna well, be honey, rich. If that's the eighth damn wonder of the world, then I'm Dolly Parton.
Almost, honey, said your hair ain't yellow.
And you must think constantly on these commandments I am giving you today. You must teach them to your children. Talk about them when you're at home, or out for a walk, and at bedtime, and first thing in the morning. Tie them on your finger, wear them on your forehead, paint them on the doorposts of your house. And then there were brought unto him little children, that he may lay his hands on them and pray. And the disciples rebuked them. But Jesus said, suffer, little children. Forbid them not to come unto me, for such is the kingdom of heaven. I must tell you, I did not sleep last night for thinking of suffering little children. How can they ever forgive us? We who stand by while their innocence is plundered. The holiness of children. Their hearts have not been touched by evil. And in their innocence, they can turn the other cheek. They will forgive you.
Jesus, keep me near the cross. There a precious fountain breathes to all our healing stream. Flows from Calvary Mountain. In the cross, be my glory ever. Till my raptured soul shall find rest beyond the
get me a swimming pool and I'm filling it with ice cubes. I'm going to Dallas and I'm getting me a charger plate with Neiman's. And then I'm going somewhere.
And we're going somewhere, Sugar.
All right. Where are we going?
Wherever you want to go.
Hollywood?
Hollywood. They'd end up putting you in the movies.
Probably. Burt Reynolds or one of them damn guys who put me in the movie. Oh, heck. Why the heck not?
I make this cake real good.
I know. I sure like it when you made the other day.
That one was chocolate. This one's applesauce.
I know. Where are the kids?
Shh. Taking their nap. I was up half the nap with them.
Oh. Where do you say we was today?
Mexico.
Oops. I just seen me Mexican. I saw Gwenny.
Rory, where's your mama keep the flour?
Oops, seen me another.
Another what?
Another Mexican.
He's just walking around out there like he don't know where he's headed.
Well, I told you, we're in Mexico today. Gonna be seeing a lot of Mexicans over here. Now, shh, the kids.
I forgot. I told my Dolores that you and me would be getting married sometime. I told her you know how to do everything.
Oh, I don't.
Yes, you do, Gemma.
Well, what'd your mama say to that?
She says it's fine by her. She say I need me someone good like that. I sure do like you, Jim.
Cut that out, Rory. That ain't no way for you to be talking.
I'll be going to work now.
Okay, have a good day. I'll have the applesauce cake ready for you when you get back. Get off early?
New hours. What's for supper?
Pork chops, baked beans, mashed potatoes, and applesauce cake for dessert.
All my favorites. Ain't the kids eating?
Well, they're taking a siesta. That's what they call a nap in Mexico.
Oh, I don't like nap.
Well, everyone does it in Mexico.
Oh. You sure are smart, Gemma.
Well, it ain't nothing. Just what I learned in school.
I wish they told me that when I was at that school place. Why do you think they didn't tell me about that? Siesta.
I bet I know that word next time you meet me. I sure do like you, Gemma. I think we ought to get married.
Rory.
No, I know what you're going to say, but I mean it. I want us to get married.
All right, Rory. I'll take care of you. I will. You and me will get married and take care of me. Let me get this cake in the oven or we'll never get done eating tonight.
I know.
Couple of years down the line, she'd get herself tangled up with one of them good-for-nothings you hang out with.
I'd just as soon have one of them and be stuck with a dummy. Funny look at him, you'd never guess there was nothing going on upstairs.
Oh, they're just kids, for Christ's sake. Let them alone, it'll pass. Besides, if they want to play house, let them. Ain't nothing wrong with that.
Nothing wrong with it? There's nothing wrong with it, except that he is a grown man and she is 13 years old.
Don't you go getting moral on me, honey. You've been at it ever since the snakes crawled out from under the tires.
About give you up. She was about to starve.
You like chicken fried steak?
Of course she does. Give me a quarter.
I don't got one.
How is it, Gemma?
You know better than to yell across the restaurant like that.
Dolores, you can bring Gemma's plate now.
She wants to hear a song. What do you want to hear?
I don't care.
See, kiddo? You cuddle up to him. You bat your eyes, you put on a little dab of perfume, and they'll give you anything.
What, Neil?
Well, you give me a quarter, didn't you?
Yeah, but...
See?
How you doing, sugar?
How is it, Gemma?
Get back in the kitchen, Rory. Scoot. Right now.
Sure is one eager boy you got yourself there. Pretty soon he's gonna want to do more than just play house.
Now stop, Juanil.
Stop what?
Stop talking that way. That ain't the way to be talking.
She knows. She knows all about it.
He must do something that I didn't do.
Oh, I feel like dancing. Thank God it's Friday. Of course, I can't get Frankie to go with me anymore.
You know I gotta go back to work, and I gotta get up at 5:30 in the morning.
Never stopped you when we met. Things is gonna start moving now. As soon as Aggie gets back from Midland.
Yeah, we just gotta be patient.
Oh, I'd love to be there in the flesh and see it. I just take off my clothes and wallow in it when it comes gushing out of the ground. Get black as a field hand. Huh, sugar, huh? Would you take off your clothes and get naked and wallowing? Give me another quarter.
I don't got another.
I gotta get out of here then. Go find Gwenny.
Are you gonna be home?
Well, long enough to sponge off and change my duds. Why?
I think.
See y'all.
You got something on your mind? I guess things will be hopping by Christmas. I'll buy you anything you want.
You were in the army, weren't you?
Yeah.
Well, my daddy was too. Were you in Vietnam?
Yeah.
When I first come here, I figured you was my daddy.
You think that? I wish I was, but I ain't.
How? Did you know him?
That boy's got to change shirts twice a night the way he sleeps.
Oh, is that all? Oh, look at you.
It's in forever, and we know.
Come on, Gemma. We go down stagecoach. Watch the dance.
Oh, all right.
Better go around back, won't you? Aggie's by it.
I'll take care of you. Thank you. Bye-bye. Why don't you let me give you a haircut?
You give me some double bubble of Tootsie Roll Pop when I'm done.
Well, I will too then.
I give him my gum now.
You're my first haircut. I didn't think I could do it, but I did.
I'd rather have a Tootsie Roll Pop if y'all got those, but I don't care.
Now, it ain't perfect, but I think it'll be okay.
I know.
Hear the music? Hey, I've got an idea. I'm going to teach you how to square dance.
I know how. I did it last year.
Yeah? Where is it you start from? What do they call it? Home. It's called home.
Home?
hand, you do this thing called honor your partner.
Uh-huh, and you go like this.
Okay, now, what position are we in?
I guess beauty shop.
Home. We're in home.
Home.
Okay, now the main step is something called a do-si-do. You go around, back to back, like this. Good. Okay, now, Rory. Okay, now the other thing I want to teach you is something called a, it's something like a marmalade. And you go.
Got a lot to remember.
Oh, it's easy, you'll see. I'll do the calling, you just follow what I do, okay? You go like this, you go around. Okay, now. Okay, everybody stand and dance right where you are. And honor your partner and the lady to your left. Okay, everybody hold hands and keep going till you get home. Okay, now everybody do-si-do. Rory? Rory? Prettier than anything I ever heard. You and me could be king and queen of the harvest ball.
Home.
Now, ain't this just what we need?
A man who loves pleasure becomes poor. Wine and luxury are not the ways to riches.
Brother, I reckon that says it all. No wonder I'm poor and I'm going to be poor till they bury me. Shoot, the way you tell it, I can't ever expect nothing out of life. I love pleasure. I love wine. And I love dragging me some big old oily smelling guy into the can down at the stagecoach.
Damn,
no! Stop it! Stop!
Never gonna be rich.
Woe to you who get up early in the morning to go on long drinking bouts that last till late at night.
I don't believe this. I ain't never gonna look any better than this. 5 years from now.
Why then should we, mere humans as we are, murmur and complain when punished for our sins? Let us examine ourselves instead and repent and turn again to the Lord.
For I ain't taking this! You understand?
It's the Lord's word!
Oh, it's nothing. It's nothing. When are you going to stop this crap? Stop this trying to lead people
around? Oh, I ain't leading.
The hell you ain't. You're just like him. You're just like the old man.
I ain't leading.
You ain't nothing special.
Come on, dead baby.
You ain't one to be telling me how to live.
After death, the judgment.
I'm sending you back.
Now, come on, baby. Come on.
I should have sent you back the morning you come. You ain't been nothing but a pain.
I ain't going back there.
You ain't staying here with me. I can't afford you now. I can't afford nothing. I want you out of here.
If my daddy was here, you wouldn't be talking like that.
Listen, you ain't ever had a daddy. Alive or dead. You understand what I'm saying? Your daddy could have been any one of a half a dozen. I don't remember much. Just that you come along right in the great big middle of it, and I was having a good time, and I had to quit. You are going back.
I ain't going back there. I don't belong there.
You don't belong anywhere, kiddo. You're just like me. You don't belong anywhere. I ain't playing with you, kiddo.
What time is it?
Doesn't matter what time it is, you're in big trouble.
It was them that was doing something, not me.
Yeah, well, I expect they wasn't reading Bible verses to each other.
I killed her. It was me that done it.
You didn't kill nobody. Gwen may have a headache for the next 5 years, but she ain't dead. If she starts talking, the cops will be in here.
Care.
Of course you care. Of course you care. I gotta get you out of here, and I gotta take you somewhere.
I don't care. I'll tell him what happened.
Oh, you will you? You'll tell him you tried to cut off his thing? Aggie take me in there, and I just about got sick. Her hanging there like shoddy plumbing, and him laying there bleeding.
Bleeding?
And my hair cutting scissors on the floor next to your Bible. Baby, you're in big trouble. Gemma, I gotta hide you somewhere.
He tried to hurt himself because he loves me.
Give up! Don't tell him nothing!
Was that him? When you come home, I'm gonna take care of you. Before
he
stabilized, we're ready to roll.
People sometimes, they think I don't know something, and I really do.
What are you talking about?
Like now. I know, Jim.
What do you know, Rory?
People sometimes, they don't listen to me. I know things.
Excuse me, miss. We have to get going.
Says she's gonna hang a picture of some mountains or something over it. So.
And I can stand at my chair all day and look over and see some pretty scenery. Snow-capped mountains, places.
Aggie's gonna carry me over to see Rory later on this weekend. She's gonna tell him I'm already 16.
They ain't never letting him out of there.
Well, Aggie says they have to keep him in there for a little while in case of infection or something.
It's time you faced up to something, kiddo. He ain't getting out. And not because he nicked himself with some dull old scissors either. Truth is, he ought have been put somewhere a long time ago.
What, you mean like a hospital?
No, I mean someplace special. If he stays like he is now, he won't be no count to anybody.
He would be to me.
Yeah, sure. Till you passed him up in age, and that wouldn't take too long. I'm sending you back first thing in the morning.
I told you I can't live there anymore.
Well, you can't live here either.
Well, then I'll just leave. I'll just get on a bus and go somewhere. You don't have to worry about me.
You're getting on a bus, kiddo, and you're going back to Twilight. He'll take you. I know he will.
No, he won't.
Sure he will. I know the two you got on. You had to. I see his expressions on your face. His voice comes out of your mouth. Shoot, he ain't so bad.
Yeah, and why'd you leave?
Oh, that was different. That was different. He'll love you.
And you won't.
That's not true. You're my baby. I can't keep you here. Don't you understand that? I tried and I couldn't pull it off. Now I'm getting you a bus ticket in the morning.
I don't want any bus ticket from you. I got my own money. I can get my own bus ticket.
Gemma. Baby.
Don't be saying that to me. You know, I don't need you. I never needed you.
Why don't you go in and lie down now? I just want to sit here. I may just sit here forever.
Say, you're up mighty early this morning. I was gonna drop you a line. I'm heading out to West Texas, I guess.
Midland?
Yeah. Yeah, gonna see what I can do about selling that property.
And then you're coming back? Yeah, I'm gonna go out, visit my pop for a couple of weeks, and I guess I'll be coming back too.
Well,
getting for them eggs nowadays.
Same as store-bought.
Only yours are farm fresh. Well,
I guess I better be getting back.
You ain't fixing to drive that thing after dark, are you?
It's all right. I do it all the time.
Worst time of the day to be on them roads, twilight. Make sure you turn on your lights.
I will. Take good care of yourself, kiddo.
Take care of yourself, Mama.
Happened to your hair?
I curled it. Had it done every week.
Oh, well, I don't like it.
Well, I do. It suits the shape of my face.
I'd have tan your hide. That's what I ought to do, taking all my money like that.
I didn't take nothing.
Liar?
Well, it was mine, too. Besides, I still got most of it.
Going off, having a high old time. You come back here expecting me to take you in.
You ain't changed a bit.
Gemma, I brought home some tomatoes. He liked them tomatoes Fisher Dixon made in the garden this year. Ain't you gonna say how I do?
Jim, I thought you were dead.
Yes'm, I reckon I was.
You were dead.
I mean to tell you, I'm saving my breath talking to the good Lord.
All that garbage. Nobody told me.
Look. It says here, Twilight Man's in satisfactory condition after being buried 15 hours. That's me. And somewhere in there, it says something about the search being called off, or would have been if it hadn't been for the persistence of Homer. Got his name in there somewhere.
You mean...
Yes, I thought I was in heaven. I looked up thinking it wasn't an angel. It was Homer, standing right there in the big middle of everybody. Next thing I know, I'm in Alma. Going to the hospital. I've been bringing stuff out of Preacher Dixon's garden every couple of days. I was gonna set a spell with Homer. Miss Dixon be stopping around for me in a bit. She's back over yonder doing some visits.
Found your hat.
Thank you, Jim.
Pop, Beecham brought you over some tomatoes.
Well, I don't reckon Homer feeling so good today. I just wait down by the road.
No, you come on in. I'm gonna fix you some coffee.
All right, right on.
Pop, why don't you let me fix you some coffee, too?
That was real good. You're a fine cook.
Thank you, Beecham.
You're welcome, Jim. Think I'll go set a spell.
Okay. Mama told me it was bad luck if you cut cornbread with a knife.
Mm, you gotta break it.
I was thinking of taking guitar lessons in the fall. It's Lawson is teaching at her house after school.
What do you want to do that for?
Well, I'd just like to learn it. Besides, we have recitals every spring, and you could come see me. Did I tell you I didn't wear these glasses when I was in Fort Worth?
No, how'd you see anything?
Sometimes I didn't. One time when me and Mama and Frank went to the drive-in, I sat through the whole picture, and I didn't even know Jamie Lee Curtis was in it.
Who that?
Movie star.
Oh.
Did I tell you about the traffic they got down there? Every time I look out the window, there's cars passing by, even after midnight.
No.
It's true. All times tonight. This was Grandma Cora's dress, wasn't it? She wore it to the harvest ball, didn't she?
How'd you know that?
Mama had a picture of y'all. Pop, do I look like Grandma?
Yes, ma'am. You do.
Nothing missing but a one-way ticket to Dallas. I can read to you a while if you want.
Oh, you can go ahead and read your Bible. I reckon I don't care.
Square your set with a smile on your face. Everybody dance right in your place. Honor your partner. And lean to your left. All join hands. Circle left. Circle left around the room. And you swing yours and lead my lump. Everybody swing. Swing. Two, three, four. Do, si, do. Do, si, do. And we'll from a.
Mr.